Hi, and welcome back to Ajua Biotech. Or welcome if this is your first time. Thank you for subscribing and thank you for giving the video a thumbs up whenever it is useful to you. In this video, we are looking at the life cycle of the deadliest malaria-causing parasite, Plasmodium falciparum. You know, there are hundreds of species of Plasmodium parasites. Five of these are currently known to cause malaria in humans. P. falciparum, as mentioned, causes the most deadly form. So we'll zoom in on its life cycle in this video. If a mosquito bites you and it is infected with a Plasmodium parasite, the parasite is in the salivary gland of the mosquito. The form of the parasite that is in the salivary gland of the mosquito is called a sporozoite. As soon as the sporozoite enters the human, within minutes to hours, it enters the liver cells of the human. There in the liver, it multiplies and develops into a stage referred to as a schizont. When the parasite reaches the schizont stage of development, it bursts out of the liver, damaging the liver cells, and emerge in a form known as a merozoite. Once free from the liver, it looks for red blood cells. The newly released merozoites enter red blood cells, where they follow various stages of development. Just like in humans, where we have various stages of development, like we have a baby, then a toddler, then an adolescent, then teenager, youth, adults, elderly stages of development, the parasite is also going to go through its own stages of development. So in the red blood cells, the RBCs, the merozoite form of the parasite first enters a stage of development known as the ring stage, also known as an early trophozoite. It then progresses to a stage known as a trophozoite, or a late trophozoite. From the trophozoite stage, the next stage of development for the parasite is a schizont. Now, just as it bursts out of the liver when it reached the schizont stage of development, it does the same thing in the red blood cells when it reaches that stage, emerging as a merozoite. So in this slide, you see the bursting of red blood cells with subsequent release of the merozoite developmental stage of the parasite. Once the merozoites are released, just like before, they also find new red blood cells to begin their own developmental stages. Just like in humans, when we reach adulthood and we start having babies of our own and continuing the developmental cycle that our parents went through to give birth to us. In Plasmodium, the release of the merozoite form of the parasite from red blood cells and reinfection of new red blood cells takes approximately 48 hours. It is this reinfection, and release that causes the symptoms associated with malaria. It's what alerts the human host that something is not quite right. So biology is complex, and while most of the merozoites will burst out of the red blood cells, a tiny minority will stay in the red blood cells and develop into male and female gametocytes. These gametocytes can only develop inside a mosquito. So when a human is bitten by a mosquito, if the human has malaria, then the parasites, specifically Plasmodium falciparum parasites, the mosquito may pick up these gametocytes. If this occurs, the gametocytes can develop it via its sexual stage into gametes. The gametes fertilize to form a zygote. This is quite analogous to the human setting where eggs and sperm fertilize. Inside the mosquito, the zygote develops into an oocanete. The oocanete form penetrates the midgut of the mosquito. It is now that the oocanete can develop and progress to a form known as an oocyst. The oocyst develops and eventually ruptures, releasing sporozoites. The sporozoites migrate to the salivary glands of the mosquito, ready to be transmitted to a human via a mosquito bite. And then the cycle continues. So that brings us to the end of this video on the malaria, or specifically Plasmodium falciparum life cycle. I will see you in the next video. God bless.